Welcome back! My name is ballerscuba. This is Video Games Over Time! We are still in 1982. Today, we're going to talk about Millipede. The story of Millipede takes us back to Atari. We of course have been talking about Atari since nearly the beginning of Video Games Over Time. Atari, however, has not been as prevalent in 1982 as previous years. We last talked about an Atari-developed product in our video on the Atari 5200. Millipede was designed by Ed Logg and Mark Cerny. We have talked about Ed Logg before. He created both Asteroids and Centipede. Mark Cerny was a new employee at Atari, and Millipede was one of his first projects. Millipede is a sequel to 1981's Centipede. The game, as a result, has a lot of similar gameplay mechanics to Centipede. Millipede is a shooter in which the player shoots at millipedes who come down from the top of the screen in a very similar manner to how Centipede is played. However, Millipede no longer has the bug blaster from Centipede. Instead, the player plays as an elf named Archer, who is defending his mushroom forest from the gigantic insects who seek to destroy it by using his magic arrows. The gameplay has also been changed slightly. The millipede itself moves faster and is harder to hit. There are also more enemies with new strategies, as well as DDT bombs that can be exploded for bonus points. Atari released Millipede to arcades in America on November 12, 1982. That is the short backstory to Millipede. With that now told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. And here we are in the game. This is Millipede, as you can see, released in 1982 by Atari on a very busy screen here. We can see some of the new enemies. We have the dragonfly, the mosquito, earwig, bee, inchworm, beetle, the DDT bomb, the millipede, of course, and the spider makes a return as well. A lot of these enemies we're probably not going to see a lot of, but we do get a chance to see some of their mechanics here. The beetle actually drives me nuts. Possibly more than anything else. One thing that I did not talk about in the intro that I love about this game is that it introduces the auto fire button. I will be using that almost exclusively here. It's not necessarily a huge deal for a lot of the major players of this game, for the dedicated players, but for me, it is a lifesaver. So, let's go ahead and drop a quarter in, see what we can do. I don't anticipate making the high score list, but I should be able to get at least one bonus. We are going to start with 0 points, thank you. All right, so the DDT, that is a pesticide that was banned in the United States by the time that this came out. It was controversial, and you don't want to waste your DDT like I just did there. I'll probably be doing that quite a bit. Yeah, that beetle crawls along the bottom, and I like staying at the bottom. And there's another wasted DDT. I'll give you a lot of them. Don't waste them. You want to use them when possible. I've only been able to really use the DDT effectively once, but we'll see what I can do this time. That was my chance. Oh, I didn't even see the beetle. Told you I hate those beetles. Wasted another DDT there. They gave me a new one. That's kind of rare. All right, we'll do what we can. As you can see, the millipede moves a lot faster, and the auto attack saves you towards the end. All right, let's just try to hang out somewhere around there. Yep, the DDT bomb is much more horizontal than vertical, so that came right for me. That was a heat seeker. Alright, the earwig, it plants some stuff that makes these guys go pretty much all the way to the bottom. Alright, I didn't even know how I got all of that, but I did. Alright, we're doing okay for ourselves so far. No. Alright, I got a free life. Yeah, they start spawning stuff from the side, and I think it's unfair because they spawn them very low. But you just kind of have to learn to deal with it. Yeah, the auto fire is so good near the bottom, right? Because you can only have one shot on screen, one arrow. so when it does spawn, so when they get close to the bottom, you can start really shooting away at it. All right, well, we did pretty well, over 20,000 points. I would need double that in order to get to the high score list, but I think that's pretty good. Let's go ahead and drop another quarter in and try again. Yeah, the game really does make improvements on the original Centipede. I would say in a good way. It makes it a little bit more frantic, and I would say that Centipede was already pretty frantic, but for a lot of... You went up way sooner than you normally do. I hate the beetle. Leave me alone. Yeah, he usually goes up around there. Centipede was already a hard game for me, so this game I think is a little bit harder simply because everything does move faster, you have more enemies, all that kind of stuff. You have to keep an eye on the beetle. Okay. All but one, there it goes. All right. This one, I don't try to necessarily get a lot of points. I just try to avoid getting hit. Okay. Yeah, when they hit those, like, mutated mushrooms, they just kind of go straight down towards the bottom. Didn't work out so well there, but close to getting another free life. Alright, slowed everything down for me temporarily, and I don't think I shot a single thing while that was happening. Come on. There we go. Alright, we got a free life out of that. I do like that little jingle that they give me for that. Okay, we're doing decently. Get away from the beetle. Spider came right for me. Once again, we're at 20,000. That seems to be about where I can go. Maybe I'll have a long life here. Yeah, still haven't taken advantage of a DDT properly, but, like, it's so rare for me. Okay. No! Oh, and then they spawned one right on top of me. All right, 22.5. I think we got one more in me, but I don't think I'm going to be able to do too much more than this. I see Ed Logg made the list, though, as did Dig Dug. We'll go with that. Right off the bat, I'm hitting a DDT. Hit that one. There we go. That was pretty good. I didn't get the full millipede, but I got quite a bit of it. That was a good use of the DDT, I would say. They trapped me there. I didn't see a way out. Spider coming one way, beetle coming the other. I used the DDT properly, and then I don't have any luck after that. For the record, okay, yeah, we're playing again. The DDT was also a wrestling move by this point, but we will talk about that in another video. But yeah, DDT, it's clearly referencing the pesticide that was very controversial and banned in the United States, at least, and banned around the world eventually. It's too powerful. There we go. No, don't hit the DDT there. Get away. Oh, I got rid of two of them, avoiding the beetle. This is why you're not really supposed to use the auto fire, but I do all the time anyway. You never know what you're gonna hit. Also, I'm supposed to be protecting my my mushroom forest, but I am doing much more destruction to it than anyone else. Come on, get here. There we go. All right. So many mushrooms now. Which is a bad thing, which is why I'm always kind of confused by the fact that I'm supposed to be saving the forest as the as Archer here. The elf named Archer. That didn't go so well. That's just mean. That's just mean. Spawned right... It just came right for me after spawning. Alright, got that one. Alright, able to get the 15,000 for the extra life again. Inchworm slows everything down for me. Not sure how helpful it was, though. 21,000. Like, once again, like, it's right around the same every time, my score. Not gonna be able to do too much better than what I've already done. And now they're spawning the extras. Alright, we got through it. No! There's so many down here! Alright, the inchworm's helping me. Oh, they spawned so many more. Oh, I am screwed here. That couldn't do it. Couldn't get to 30,000. There was just so much. All right, but that was my best one so far, and I think that's a good spot to end it. So that is the game now played, and with the game now played, it's time to talk about how it holds up today. Playing the game today, I do have to say that the game is fun. It is a game that I enjoyed playing. With that said, it's almost impossible to not compare the game to Centipede as you talk about Millipede, so I'm going to do that. Overall, I would say Millipede is an improvement over Centipede. With the faster pace, the additional enemies, the additional strategies that are involved, I think it gives more to the player than the original game. So overall, it is a net positive, the transition from Centipede to Millipede. With that said, I feel that the game is harder than Centipede, at least that's the impression that I get while playing it. It is a harder game, and I was already struggling with Centipede, but it's still fun. It's still a game that I enjoy playing. It's not going to prevent the insane runs that you can get if you are very good at the game. As of recording it today, the world record is 10,627,331 by Donald Hayes. He did that in 2004. Keep in mind that my number was around 20,000. I was struggling for 30,000. So to get over 10 million is quite intense and not something that I would ever even really attempt to do. The game is fun, but I think it's fun in shorter bursts. I really don't see myself playing it for longer than 10-15 minutes at a time before I want to do something else. It's not something that I personally can sink a lot of time into, but clearly there are people that can. In terms of the graphics, I feel that the graphics aged more poorly than Centipede simply because Millipede came out when there was an advancement in graphics. We have seen much better graphics in other games, and it makes Millipede, whose graphics are very comparable to Centipede, it didn't age as well because of the time that it came out. The sound also was very much similar to Centipede, and therefore it doesn't really convey what is going on. It didn't necessarily feel like I was shooting arrows and destroying things, but it's nice to have all the different jingles, basically, for all the different enemies on the screen, for getting the extra life. I do appreciate that, and those were nice. It just didn't sound like what I was doing was being conveyed to me back. It didn't feel like I was shooting arrows with the sound. It didn't feel like I was destroying enemies with the sound that it would make when I would hit them. It didn't sound like I was destroying mushrooms or anything like that. The sound was a little lacking for me in this game, but Like I said, overall, it is a fun game, and I think that the gameplay overshadows some of the technical aspects that are holding the game back, I would say. So, playing the game today, I would say it is worth checking out, at least for a little bit. Maybe not something that you spend a lot of time in, but definitely something that is worth a little bit of your time. And that's my modern take on the game. When the game was released, it proved to be popular. Millipede would become one of the best-selling arcade cabinets of 1983. This popularity would result in a European release in April 1983. Atari would reach out to Namco to publish Millipede in Japan, but that would not happen until 1984. Millipede would spawn ports and re-releases. We will be keeping an eye on these as we continue. As you might expect, we will also continue to keep an eye on Atari as we continue. They are still the biggest name in the video game industry. As for Ed Logg, he would continue to work at Atari creating video games. We will hear from Ed Logg again. As for Mark Cerny, he would also continue to work at Atari creating video games, and we will hear from Mark Cerny again as well. That will do it for the story of Millipede for now. My name is ballerscuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video when we take scrolling in a whole new direction.